Hey guys, we're back. It's the next day and our silicone has fully cured from our last experiment where we took a vacuum chamber and sucked all the air bubbles out of the silicone first. The idea being that now our PokeBall molds should be completely bubble free. So now we get to see if that's really the case. Now you've already seen me rip these off and cut them open in a previous video, so I'm not gonna spend a lot of time doing that here. Let's just dive right in and get it done. Cool guys, so we got our silicone molds out of the casings, and if you look down here where the clay was, you can see it makes a really cool cavity, and so now when we pour molten aluminum, wax, or even gummy syrup, it's gonna have a reservoir to draw from as it cools and shrinks. I did notice on this one, however, the clay was pushed up a little bit too high into the ball, and that creates a bit of a problem because now the ball is exposed. That means the inside of this ball mold isn't fully complete. The cool thing about silicone is even though it's cured, we can add more, and it will fuse in and make one solid chunk of silicone. So even though we messed up here and didn't completely cover the ball, we can just mix up a little bit more, pour that in, and when it sets, it should be perfect. The only problem is we only need about 1 tablespoon of silicone, and I got 5 gallons of the stuff. This looks like white frosting. It's really cool. Now we're not gonna need a lot of silicone, so I just mixed up about 100 grams worth here, and honestly, we're probably gonna waste more than we actually use, but when you're dealing with quantities this small, there's not much else we can do. Now I am gonna stick this in the vacuum chamber as well. And one interesting thing about this vacuum chamber is if you look at this gauge, it's still suctioned up. I set this last night and sucked it down to about 25 inches of mercury. And interestingly enough, over the entire night, it's only slipped down to about 23. And the vacuum pump is not running. It's just maintaining vacuum pressure with these valves here. So I thought that was pretty cool. And it means our proto putty seal is working as intended. Sweet, that's the stuff right there. Just made it to the lip of that cup, and now the bubbles are being extracted, so we just need that to settle down and it should be good to pour. See, that suction's on pretty good. And our glass jar is not exploding. That's always a plus. And now, if we just drizzle this straight over this Pokeball until the bottom is covered, we should be in business. All right, let's call that good. It's stuck. This bottom is actually so smooth that if I slam it down on a hard surface, it creates a suction cup that's actually very difficult to get back off. Oh, wow! Impressive. Maybe we could use silicone to make our own suction cups. Now before we cut this thing open, you guys tell me in the comments, do you think we made a mold that came out bubble free? I'm a little bit nervous and a little bit excited to find out because I have no idea. There we go. Another successful extraction. So cool. Now another little tweak I made to these Pokeballs before I stuck them in the silicone, I took a bead of hot glue and wrapped it on the inside to prevent the silicone from seeping in. It looked like it actually worked out pretty well that time. We don't have these things loaded up with silicone, so yay. All right, so the moment of truth. How does it look on the inside? Let's take a peek. Oh yeah, that is actually looking really good. I see nothing but smooth silicone. No bubbles this time. That's a dramatic difference from our last mold. If you remember, our last one was pocked with bubbles everywhere, and this one looks completely smooth. That is very encouraging. I like that. Yeah, that looks just about perfect. All we have to do now is trim up some of the flaps here. You can see where it leaked into the balls a little bit. But if we can trim those up, I think we're gonna have ourselves a pretty dang nice Pokeball mold.
Like a surgeon.
So cool guys, our mold is looking awesome. I'm really excited to see how our wax casting is gonna turn out. But before we cast the wax, there are a few suggestions from my friend Nate about how to make this work a little bit better. First of all, maybe we should put this in the microwave for about 3 minutes to warm the silicone up. Second of all, when we pour the wax in here, let's start off with a little bit and rotate the mold around so it coats the inner walls of the mold first. And after we fill this thing up with wax, let's throw it in a vacuum chamber for a couple of minutes to see if there's any air in molten wax. If we follow all those suggestions perfectly, I'm fairly confident we're gonna end up with a perfect wax Pokeball. So our mold just came out of the microwave. It's nice and toasty warm right now, and our wax is completely molten. So let's pour the wax. Beautiful. All right, I'm gonna stop there for just a second. So what I'm doing now is I'm just rotating this gently to put a nice wax coating on the inner walls of the mold. The idea being that that will fill in any gaps and prevent any air bubbles. Let's pour the rest. Okay, now at this point, I'm just gonna stop for a second and put this thing in the vacuum chamber to see if there are any air bubbles in there we can suck out first. Oh, I see some bubbles rising there. Interesting. Wow, that's incredible. So I'm not really sure where those bubbles are coming from, whether they're leaking through the cracks in the side of the silicone mold, or if these are actually bubbles that were in the wax itself. But in either case, I'm feeling a lot more confident now that we've run them through a cycle in the vacuum chamber. All right, let's release the pressure. Super cool. Beauteous. There's our wax, hopefully bubble free. It's interesting, it also looks like the wax has shrunk down a little bit. I wonder if that's because it's cooled in the vacuum. But in either case, we're just gonna top this thing off so it's got a nice reservoir to draw from. There we go, right to the very top, and we'll see how much that actually shrinks down. Yeah, so this is pretty exciting, guys. We're making some good progress, and I'm pretty confident that our wax right now is bubble-free. So we've got an awesome silicone mold, we've got our wax poured, and I'm actually feeling very good that this is gonna work out. All we have to do now is give this a few hours just to cool down and set, and we can open this mold up and see how that wax ball turned out. So these things just came out of the fridge. I had them sitting overnight just so they could fully harden up. And if you look at the tops of them, you can see how when the wax cooled down, it actually shrunk. But because we've got those reservoirs in there, it didn't make any noticeable difference at all. So the time has come where we can open these things up and see what kind of quality casting we actually got. Oh, this peels apart really nicely. Hey, look at that, guys. That is looking beautiful. We got a perfect Pokeball casting. I am very happy about that. This is our battle-tested Pokeball, and those lines came out looking really clean. You know what else is cool is these grooves here. I thought maybe air bubbles could get trapped up in there because it was sitting upright, but by painting the silicone in there, it looks like we completely eliminated that problem. I mean, those lines are all crisp. Look how sharp those edges are. That looks amazing. We have a little bit of like residual silicone in there that just needs to be pulled out, but that looks great. All right, let's check out the blue. It's like Christmas. Oh goodness, that's looking amazing. Now last time I made wax Pokeballs, somebody suggested why not drill a hole in there, put a little wick, and make it into a candle. So why not indeed? Let's do that with our blue one. I've still got a wick from the blue candle, so if we just drill a hole right through the center and put it in, I think that might just work. I got our little Pokebomb. That looks awesome. So guys, I'm calling that a success. We have two really awesome wax castings that you can make into wax candles or use for casting aluminum Pokeballs. Hey, thanks for joining me for this project. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. Oh gosh. Wow. Hey guys, thanks for watching, and remember, I'm giving away prizes now on every new video. All you have to do to qualify is subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and select to be notified when my next videos get released. The secret link to my giveaways will be pinned in the comments for the first 12 hours. If you like what I'm doing, show your support right now by giving this video a big thumbs up and share with a friend. I love you back, and I'll see you next time.